Hello. Welcome. You must be the 9 o'clock for today. Yes. Well, welcome to the Conscious Clinic. We have a wide variety of services, as I'm sure you've seen on our website. But today, you're going to be doing the Conscious Questionnaire. Yes, it's an interesting test. I'm going to be asking you a series of 25 questions, all related to more or less what your current state of mind is. Some of the questions are on the deep end, and you're encouraged to speak as much or as little as you like for each question. So, feel free, take as much time as you'd like. So, with these questions, we need to have you in a what's called an alpha brainwave state. It's where the mind is in a very relaxed state and is susceptible to thoughts between the two hemispheres of the brain. So to do that, I'd like you to take a seat and begin a series of deep breathing exercises. Okay? So, once you're comfortable, good. Okay. So, we're going to be doing what's called square breathing. You may have heard of it, but it's a sports psychologist technique. We're going to be inhaling for 3 counts, holding the breath for 3 counts, exhaling for 3, and you guessed it, holding for 3. And then we restart the square once more. Okay. So, are you ready? Good. So, breathe in. Just like that. Do that as many times as you need to enter a fully relaxed state. Okay? So once you've done that, just let me know when you're ready, and I'll begin asking you with the first question. Okay. Let me get it set up in the meantime. So, we start with an easy one. What is your name? Have you ever gone by any other names? Even nicknames? Where were you born? I mean the actual location where you were born. Was it a hospital? Do you remember the hospital? What time of year was it? Question 3. How old are you? Simple enough, right? Question 4 is when we start getting into the interesting ones. How old do you think you would be if you didn't know your own age? You think so? Okay. Question 6. What are you avoiding? In general, yeah. Anything. Question 7. What do you want? In general, yeah. Okay. Anything else? Question 8. Who are you? Interesting. I like the way you're answering that. Question 9. What do you really want? Are you certain about that? Okay. Question 10. What would your life be like if you didn't hold yourself back? I think a lot of people would say the same thing. Anything else you'd like to add? Question 11. What are you willing to sacrifice to get what you want? Yeah, Yes, it can be anything, physical or mental. Your principles, for example. Your morals. Your love. You can sacrifice those things too. Question 12. What would you never sacrifice, no matter the reward? Yeah, something that is invaluable to you. It can be an object, but it usually isn't. Are you sure about that? Okay. So, question 13. What does the voice inside your head sound like? It's interesting. For me, I've always heard a older American gentleman from like turn of the 20th century. Even when I was a kid, I don't know what that means. Okay. Question 14. What are your thoughts made of? Well, sure. All thoughts are technically electrical signals, but think of it more in metaphorical or symbolic terms. Question 15. How do you know that you are real? Well, if you don't know, and that's an interesting perspective to take, imagine if you knew. Imagine if you knew that you were real and there was no doubt. What would it take for you to know that you were real in that instance? I like that. It's interesting. It's a perspective I heard before. Okay. 16. Have you ever looked at yourself in a dream? So, do psychedelic drugs count? It would depend. Under very high doses, I would say that experience would count. But, with any real semblance of conscious control, I would say that's mostly just your imagination. It needs to be what your subconscious mind has conjured for you. Question 17. To what degree have you actually controlled the course your life has taken? Most people will be surprised to realize just how little they have. Question 18. What do you do differently from what other people do? It could be anything, just as long as you do it differently. Delete that last part. Okay. Keep going. That's good. Anything else that you do differently? It can even be thoughts. Yeah, that would definitely separate you. Okay. Question 19. Why are you yourself? Free associate with that possibility. Does that make you you uniquely, or does that make you as part of a group? Because there is a difference. No, keep going. Question 20. Well, before I ask these next two, some people sometimes have a hard time with them because they bring up emotional pain or anxiety. So I'll give you a moment and do a couple more of those square breathings, okay? Yeah, remember, so it's in, hold, exhale, and then hold for three again. Yeah, do a couple of those. Get yourself in that alpha brainwave state. Ready? Okay. Question 20. When was the last time you told someone you love them and didn't? Time on that one. It's okay. You can keep going. Okay. Question 21. When was the last time you wanted to tell someone that you love them? That can be a tough question for a lot of people. But it's okay. That's life sometimes. Were you alone, or were you with other people? Okay. That's a pretty good time. Question 23. What would you have done differently if you weren't afraid? Important events or decisions. Yeah, a lot of people end up relating this back to question 20 and 21. Was that the most terrifying time in your life? Question 24. If you turned this video off, would I still be typing? like that. Now for the final question. Question 25. How do you know you're not dreaming right now? You've given quite a number of really good answers to this conscious report. And I think the software is really gonna find some interesting patterns here. Oh, right. So what we're gonna be doing with this information is running it through some software that it's going to look for certain linguistic and rhetorical patterns of speech, and it's going to produce a score and an analysis based upon that. It's been peer-reviewed, peer-tested against thousands of other people, so it can compare to a large number of other people who have answered the same 25-question test, and the results can be pretty interesting. But what I do with the results, that is going to be entirely up to you, how you want to handle them. So, once the software is complete, we're going to be sending the results to you in a secure email. And after that, it's up to you. There's basically three ways you can take it from there. Some people, they never read it. They simply allow themselves to figure what the results might be. Other people, they read it immediately. They want to know what the software has to say about them, and if that reflects what they really think. And then other people, they read it, but not after a long time. Not until after a long time. Maybe a few weeks, a month, maybe even some years, but they use it as a way to reflect back and picture that time in their life and see if they've changed since then. So, it's up to you. So, with that in mind, it'll be about 3 to 5 business days before it's totally ready. And then after that, you can deal with it as you'd like. Alright. Well, thanks for coming today. And I hope you found this interesting, maybe a little bit relaxing, introspective, but ultimately fulfilling. So, thanks for coming.